Hi, I'm Dan Riddell. I'm the product manager for Mission Control at Torc Robotics.
Hi, I'm Cruz Joyner. I am the logistics specialist for fleet ops in Albuquerque for Torc Robotics.
So Cruz, tell me about your job as a dispatcher and how that is changing and set to change with the introduction of autonomous vehicles.
My role in dispatching started out in the dairy industry. So freight was a little bit different as opposed to autonomy. It was it's completely different compared to what I do now. It's autonomous. Like we're currently testing these trucks and preparing for freight. So what I pay attention to now, as opposed to back then, is the health of the truck, the cameras, the stability of the ADS system, weather, traffic in real time. When you're in conventional logistics, it's a little bit different. You won't worry so much about that as you rely on the driver to take care of that.
Well, especially coming from dairy, do you guys have a lot of like the old pen and paper logs, and you're still like out of the phone and hand jamming stuff?
Yeah, that goes back to the books. Again, that wasn't electronic back then. The ELD wasn't around back then. It was books. It was paper inspection forms. It was everything. Like everything was stored in a filing cabinet for months on end, as opposed to now, as everything is electronic.
So coming from completely analog paper systems, going all the way to, end-to-end digitization from a paper log that a driver is making notes in, all the way to not only just an ELD, but effectively an ELD plus, where you've got so much data that we were able to pull from the truck. But the way that we were using those digital tools was very different, right? You're still scheduling out for a manual loads, manual drivers, all that other good stuff. And it's really interesting to see the level of data fidelity that we're able to grab here utilizing Mission Control down to, a pinpoint GPS location. Whereas in a past life, I would be calling someone and hoping to get an ETA within a 3-hour span. Now I can tell down to which intersection this truck just drove through.
Yeah, man, I'm old, but they didn't have cell phones that they were able to use in the trucks. We didn't have, that technology was climbing into it as I was leaving that part of logistics. And I stepped away for a few years from the logistics end. But yeah, we had to pull over, pull into truck stops and actually call back to base and get updates, give updates, for delay times.
On a payphone.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, and I'm not that old.
But I'm giving you
a time. Yeah, but that's how it was back. Everything was, you wouldn't hear from the driver or know where the driver was at for hours on end. If not full shifts, and until that driver or the dispatcher, they communicate. So it's completely different. We know exactly where the trucks are at.
And how does that impact your ability to schedule, for instance? Or how did it when you didn't have those accurate ETAs and things like that?
You would schedule on a forecasting basis, just based off of the assumption that the truck's going to be operational and ready to go. And the driver's going to be available at the time. The driver may not have been available and you thought he was. Now, with the truck and where the trucks are going, we know exactly what's happening. Before the truck even spins up, like we already know the heartbeat of the loggers for the software, the logger health. If we're going to be able to deploy that software into the truck, from the ground all the way up to the truck is ready to go.
Which is kind of crazy when you think about it, because it's not that long ago that you walked out to a truck and you may or not. Barring an inspection, which you obviously had to do, that truck may or may not actually work. And now we're able to pull that data and deliver it to you remotely, even in some cases before the driver's been able to inspect it. Obviously, the driver inspection is a crucial component of that. The base truck still exists. But for any of these codes in the background, we can present that.
Yeah, we know the night before if the truck is going to be stable enough to run today. Based off of the data that was dumped last night, different resources give us that option to do that. And that tells us, you know, that the night before that run went really well, we can utilize this truck to do that. There was no issues with the truck. And if there was issues, we would know about it. We'd shift over to another truck. Like, it eliminates the whole guessing game. You know, now everything is right in front of us at any given moment. It's pretty wild.
And I'd have to assume that does simplify your job in terms of eliminating that guessing game of, well, what truck's going to be up? Do I actually have capacity tomorrow? You're able to make those decisions proactively because we're able to pull this information and display it.
Yeah, it allows us to forecast and schedule and plan more efficiently, knowing that 80% of the time that schedule, that load is gonna get picked up. Like, we couldn't do that back then. Now we know that's gonna happen. Like, we can forecast weeks on end without any question, just based off of data.
You mean the truck's not gonna get sick? Not gonna call in sick, not gonna miss a birthday?
Yeah, if I'm gonna call in sick, it's gonna follow all DOT regulations. We're able to, with mission control, we're able to track live weather, live road conditions. Again, the truck heartbeat, like, we're able to track all that when it happens. So our reaction time has been heightened that much more.
That's really cool to hear.
It is. It's pretty cool. Like, I still get, I've been with the company about a year, and we're going on a year now, and I still get blown away from it. Like, by it, it's insane.
I'm the exact same way. Anytime that I'm around these trucks, it's just magic, and it's so fantastic.